6, 243 miles an hour.
We don't
J.R. Gray, the leader of the NHRA FuelTech Pro Mod Showdown. Driving up the side of the stage. Here's J.R. 3.
Canadian in Pro Mod comes down to Gatorland and chomp, chomp, chomps on the competition. Justin Bond, you're a Gator Nationals winner.
Yes, thank you very much.
So, Justin, it seemed like a lot of drivers out there had their hands full all day. What were the conditions like for you all in Pro Mod? Pro Mod's hard to drive anyway, but it seemed like going straight was tough today.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to, like, bad talk the track or nothing like that. It was just the track was tricky. I think my crew read the conditions real well. I mean, we were shaking. I pedaled it one run. I mean, in all the drag racing, not Pro Mod, you on the days you win, you always have a lucky round. And I always say I'd rather be lucky than good. And I think I drove good, but I had a lucky round. We pedaled it one round and got by. And in the final, it shook but didn't shake as bad as Jared Gray's car. I didn't have to pedal it. It managed to clean itself up, but it was tricky out there. When we managed to just keep our lane all weekend and did our burnouts a certain way to try to keep the starting line as best we could and just did our thing, ran our race.
Justin, 2023, a lot of announcements have been made for Pro Mod that are positive. Do you feel like Pro Mod's getting its due in the NHRA?
Yeah, I think that I'm a part of the committee of drivers that are working hard to get Pro Mod back on its feet, and we're not going to walk, we're going to run. Our committee is going to put this class back on track and make it the best it's ever been.
Justin Bond, he is the Pro Modified Gator Nationals winner.